Hey everyone, this is Dave from Heaviosity, and I'm here to take you on a little bit deeper dive of the stage feature of the Ensemble Designer in Damage 2. So jumping right in, you'll see I've loaded Armageddon 2, which is more of a menu preset. You can see by the number next to the name, there's 17 actual sources, and they're mapped across these three banks on the bottom. Bank 1, Bank 2, and Bank 3. You'll notice that I have the Follow MIDI button engaged, which allows me to switch between banks based upon the keys that I'm playing and the sources I'm hitting. So, looking at the stage, each bank is mapped individually on the stage as a smaller ensemble to keep things a little better organized. Directly beneath the stage, you'll see that there's a mix section with 5 discrete mic positions: Close, Room, Hall, LFE, and Crush. You can tweak the levels of the individual mic positions to change the overall sound of the stage. For example, if you want a bigger, wetter sound, you can take away some of the close mic and add in more of the hall. Also worth mentioning is the drum tab that has per source parameters that you can also tweak on the stage page. Keep in mind that this stage is global, so all of the mic position settings will affect each of the three banks. If you're really pressed for time and want to change the dimensions of the stage quickly, you can actually grab these handles on the right-hand side. Taking the back handle and moving it towards the front will create a more intimate sound. On the other hand, pulling the front handle towards the back will create a more ambient, wet sound to the stage. Obviously, you can just click and drag on sources and move them around the stage, but there's actually a number of shortcuts that you can use to do things more quickly. For example, if you hold down the Option key on the Mac, which is the Alt key on the PC, click on a source and drag, you'll notice that all the sources in that bank will drag simultaneously while maintaining their position in relation to one another. This is really great for changing the dimensional depth of the bank on the stage or the stereo pan of the overall bank on the stage. Clicking on a source while holding down Command on a Mac or Control on a PC will return that source to the center of the stage. Holding down Command Option on a Mac or Alt Control on a PC while clicking a single source will return all the sources in that bank to the center of the stage. Finally, clicking on an empty location on the stage while holding down Option on a Mac or Alt on the PC will randomize the locations of all the sources in that bank on the stage. This is obviously a really easy way to scatter the sources in a bank in terms of depth and their placement in the stereo field. It's also a really easy way to uncluster a number of sources that might be in the same location on the stage. One final thing to be aware of: if you disengage the stage by clicking on this button, all of the sources in all of the banks will maintain their stereo field perspective in terms of where they're placed. However, all of the sources will be placed and defaulted to the center of the stage in terms of depth. Hopefully these few tips will help you get more out of the stage in Damage 2.